Yeah, on my last album, I talked about how to avoid ass whippings when you move south. On this album, I want to talk about how to create some ass whippings. We know that the current state of affairs in our great nation has many civilians up in arms and excited to join the military. For those of you who can't join, you can still lend a hand. Here are a few of the areas we would like your assistance in with the Bubbas of America. The next time you see any adults talking or wearing a hat during the playing of the national anthem, kick your ass. When you witness firsthand somebody burning the American flag in protest, while it may be within the law, just kick your ass anyway. Regardless of the rank they held while they served in the military, pay the highest amount of respect to all veterans. If you see someone doing otherwise, quietly pull them aside and explain that these veterans fought for the very freedom that they use every second as they are Americans. Enlighten them on the many sacrifices these veterans made to make this nation great. Then hold them down while some disabled veteran kicks their ass. If you were never in military, do not pretend that you were. Wearing battle dress uniforms or jungle fatigues you got down at the local Army Navy store, telling others that you used to be Special Forces, and collecting G.I. Joe memorabilia might be okay when you were 7 years old. Now it will only make you look stupid and you'll get an ass whipping anywhere in the South. Next time you come across an Air Force member, do not ask them, "Do you fly a jet?" Not everybody in the Air Force is a pilot. Such ignorance deserves an ass kicking. Children, however, are exempt under 10 years of age. If you witness somebody calling the Coast Guard non-military, inform them of their mistake, ask them if they've ever been in a boat that was about to sink 50 miles offshore, and then give them an ass whipping. Next time, Old Glory, the U.S. flag, prances by during a parade, get on your damn feet and pray homage to her by placing your hand over your heart. Quietly thank the military member or veteran lucky enough to be carrying her. Of course, failure to do so, either one of these, should earn you a severe ass-kicking. Your mama wears combat boots never made any sense to me. Stop saying it. If she did, she would most likely be a veteran and would therefore kick your ass. Flyboy, Air Force, Jarhead, the Marines, Grunt, the Army, Squid, Navy, Puddle Jumpers, the Coast Guard, are terms of endearment when these people are describing each other. Unless you are a service member or a veteran, you have not earned the right to use them. And using them anywhere near a Bubba might get you a severe ass whipping by several Bubbas. Last but not least, whether or not you become a member of the military, support our troops and their families. Every Thanksgiving and religious holiday that you enjoy with family and friends, please remember that there are literally thousands of soldiers, sailors, Marines, airmen far from home wishing they could be with their families. Thank God for our military and the sacrifices they make every day. Without them, our country would get its ass kicked by any third world country that wanted to out there. It's the veteran, not the reporter, who has given us the freedom of the press. It's the veteran, not the poet, that has given us the freedom of speech. It's the veteran, not the community organizer, who gives us the freedom to demonstrate. It's the military who salutes the flag, who serves beneath the flag, whose coffin is draped by the flag, who allows the protester to burn the flag. Now I'm asking you, do you agree with that? Yeah, baby, yeah. That's what I'm talking about, some ass whipping, patriotic ass whippings. Let's spread them around.